the study that was done out of England, and what they did is they actually have a longitudinal cohort study where they follow people over a long period of time, looking at many things, one of which was memory and thinking. They actually measured that in public servants, so they agreed to be part of the study and came in for measurements in the beginning of the 80s and 90s and now in 2000s. The reason it's big news is because up until this study came out, people really felt that until the ages of 55, 60, or even 70, there really was no significant cognitive decline. In fact, there was a summary of all the data that was available that came out in the mid-90s, and the conclusion was there really was no significant decline that occurred prior to the age of 60 or so. In terms of what this means for people as they age, I think it's hard to say, and the reason is comes back to the study that was done. The study was done, looked at people at year one and measured their memory, and then again at year 10, but then it grouped everybody together. And the question that remains is maybe some group of those people were in the prodromal stages of Alzheimer's disease or another brain disease, and they could have had quite a bit of decline, and another group of people may have had no decline, but once you group them together, overall the average decline shows up. And we don't know that answer now with the study that was done. There is some good evidence that up to 12 to 15 years prior to the onset of Alzheimer's disease, people will have measurable cognitive decline. And so maybe some of the people in those groups that were studied in England as part of the study were actually part of the prodromal, in the prodromal phase, and some were not. I think the take-home message is that this is one piece of the puzzle. So this is one study that is different from many prior studies, so it needs to be replicated. We need to have another study that confirms this is the case. And I think we need to do further study to determine if any average person or any individual had the same amount of decline that the study showed. And I think it's a bit too soon to become very concerned about our cognitive or memory decline in our 40s and 50s. In terms of what people can do to prevent memory loss, I can't tell you things that I guarantee will work. There's a number of associations that I'm going to mention and things that might be helpful, but there's nothing proven that I can give someone to prevent memory loss. We know there's a number of medical problems and illnesses that are associated with memory loss and dementia, which is progressive memory loss in late life. One is midlife hypertension, so high blood pressure in your 30s, 40s, and 50s. Another one is diabetes. Another one is high cholesterol. There also are a number of lifestyles that are associated with either an increased or decreased risk of memory loss or dementia as we age. One is smoking. It's never too late to stop smoking. Even somebody who's in late life who stops smoking will have a reduced risk of memory loss throughout the rest of their life. Another one is being overweight, but that mainly increases someone's risk in midlife. So if they're overweight in late life, it's actually probably to their advantage. So being underweight or thin when you're very old is a bad sign. Being overweight in midlife is bad for your health and increases the risk of memory loss, especially if it's around the middle. We think the being overweight in the trunk or the belly increases the risk of memory loss and dementia even more. Of those lifestyles that I mentioned, I can say there's a number of studies that suggest an association between changing those and having a lower risk of memory loss or dementia. We here at Penn State Hershey are also involved in this type of research. We have an ongoing study very similar to the one that was done in England, where we study people over a period of time. And we're most interested in whether nutritional effects, things in our diet, such as heavy metals, affect our risk of memory loss and dementia. And can we fix those by changing our diet or changing our activity or our mental activity? And we're finding many of the same things that were found in England.